know yourself?
Not really.
So how are you guys living when you don't know yourselves?
Okay, Naomi, this is gonna make us let go, but no way.
Seriously. Masa, seriously, do you know yourself?
No.
Right, that's the easiest answer, no.
I don't know who I am.
Driving on a normal Sunday to Surprise Place, we get closer and closer. Weird feelings come into my heart. We didn't know where we were going or what to expect. Suddenly we turn into the Memorial Garden. So many things run through my mind. This is the place I thought I'd never be at while I was still alive.
Before our graveyard experience, I wasn't really worried about death because I thought I had time. I had already been through those "don't be attached to this world because it's temporary" speeches way too many times. But seeing all those tombstones of people far younger than myself gave me the feeling that death could approach me at any time, any age, and any second even.
I never really thought about death before, but going to the graveyard opened my eyes. Before, I thought dying was scary because you lose everything in this world and you don't know what's going to happen to you next. Now I realize you don't need anything, and if you live a good life, then there's nothing to be scared of.
One thing that I'll never forget about that day is that it's never too late to go in the way of God, so you can always ask for forgiveness knowing that you'll be given a second chance.
We got there and I saw the grave of a little baby boy who was born one day and died the same day. This proves that we can't say when death is for some of us. It just happens without us wanting it to happen.
Death does not discriminate gender, age, race, or religion. It is for all. Every road will end one day.
What is the first thing that comes into your mind when you hear the word death?
What word?
Death. D-E-A-T-H.
Oh, that word. Akhirat, you know? Judgment Day. That's what comes to my mind.
Are you scared of death?
I would like to say no, but I am.
Why?
You know, my Hamlet. Not very proud of it.
Do you think you'll have light in your grave?
That's a hard question. At this moment, no.
Why?
Because I've done some things.
Are you happy with where you are?
In life?
Yeah. Like where you stand?
Could be better, but, you know, what I should.
Do you know where you stand?
It's a difficult question. What do you mean, like, level? Like, spiritually, like... Excuse me, no. Yeah.
What is the first thing that pops into your mind when you hear the word death?
Graveyard.
Can you elaborate on that, please?
The end of life and the beginning of something else.
Thank you. Are you scared of death?
picture of dying.
Why?
It's not really, I wouldn't mind dying in my sleep, but I mean, I'm scared of how I'm going to die. Like, I don't want to drown or be run over by a car or have cancer or something.
Okay, are you happy with where you stand, like, right now? Let's say you die. You die, like, now, okay? Where do you stand? Do you think you'll have light or not in your grave?
Oh, light in my grave?
I'd like to think so, yeah. You like to think so, or you know? Elaborate on that.
I'm not God, I don't know.
But do you, like, do you have, like, that gut feeling that there's going to be light shining on you?
I do, but I don't want to say, because I feel like that's, like,
no, just say whatever. Yeah,
I'll end up not going to heaven by jinxing it. Yes, I feel like I'll go to heaven. Good.
Thank you.
Is that it?
Oh, okay. What is the first thing that comes into your mind when you hear the word death?
Hold on. You're unprepared for that one.
Are you scared of death?
No.
Why?
Because you're reaching God.
So you think you'll have light in your grave?
Inshallah.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So you're happy with where you are right now?
No.
Then how do you know you'll have light in your grave?
Because I'm working and striving to improve.
But at this moment, if you're not happy with where you are, how do you know you'll have light in your grave?
God's mercy.
Thank you. Okay. I don't really have a favorite celebrity, but I have, like, a few songs that are my favorite. First of all, I'm obsessed with this guy named mohebban-e-fatemeh. Oh my goodness, his songs are, like, Hot 99.5, but for Islam. And then there's this one song by, what's her name, Christina Aguilera, Hurt. Nightmare doesn't like her, but that's fine, because I still like her. And I am going to listen to them right now. I don't have a favorite celebrity, and I don't have a specific singer. I just like songs from different people.
What's the deal with that guy?
Okay, their mom is fighting, like their parents are fighting. Like, this one has cancer and she's accepting herself.
She has a big... Okay, so my favorite person ever is David Villa Sanchez. He's a Spanish soccer player, number 7, on Barcelona. His birthday is December 2nd. He's 29. He's from Astoria, Spain. He's 5'9". He's 150 pounds. Yeah, I know a lot about him. Yeah, he's married.
Okay, Dory, do you know yourself?
Not really.
Okay, why?
Because I feel like I pretend to be what others want me to be instead of being who I really am.
Why is that?
Because I care more about what others think than, like, how I really act or the real person inside me.
So, what's your identity?
What do you mean?
Like, explain, like, what, who you are, or, like,
describe yourself.
Describe yourself.
Okay. I don't know. I haven't ever thought about that.
Do you know who you are?
Yeah, I know.
How much do you know about yourself?
Do you want to, like, describe that? You know who you are?
Mm-hmm.
Who are you?
I'm a person.
Can you give me categories?
Like, are you Muslim? Are you Asian?
Okay, I'm Muslim. Yeah, that's fair.
How much do you know about yourself?
I know that I'm Muslim. I know that... I don't know anything about myself.
What do you think is preventing you from knowing yourself? Not much. Honestly, I don't think I've tried to know myself. I think I prevented myself.
Okay. How?
Is that the West accepts this kind of action. It doesn't matter how much so-called collateral damage there is.
Whichever side kills last says it is a response to the one before. In the grim calculus of this conflict, around 3 Palestinian civilians die for every Israeli killed. It's an equation that keeps old hatreds fresh.
This is Honey and this is my message. Our generation is so occupied with this temporary world, they are lost when it comes to who they truly are and where they stand in this life.
This is Massa and this is my message. We need to be more aware of reality and not be so caught up in unimportant things.
This is Sarah and this is my message. We are so caught up in our daily lives, not even thinking about when our end is going to come, when we have to leave everything we have behind.
This is Dorian, this is my message. We are all in our own world. We all know more about music and fashion instead of knowing who we really are. We all think about how we're going to have a happy future and amazing life. We pretend to be what others want us to be instead of being who we truly are. We just need to wake up and get back to reality.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, In a time of darkness and greed, it is your light that we need. You came to teach us how to live, Muhammad, Ya Rasulullah. You were so caring and kind, your soul was full of light. Mankind, Muhammad, خير خلق الله.